Okay, so Joe Biden, President Joe Biden, had his super duper important big boy press conference. His own team, more than one, actually described his press conference as being a big boy press conference. Why in the hell would they use that term to describe a press conference? Because it's the first full press conference he's had in about 8 months. And he's clearly not able to really do them on a regular basis. He's struggling to do his job. And now people are questioning his ability. The media is pretending like they didn't know. Oh, we didn't know he had these cognitive issues. They're completely full of it. So they're working overtime, try to prove that they're journalists. Okay. A lot of people aren't going to buy it. A lot of people aren't going to trust them anymore. Anyway, they hyped up this press conference. Even before the press conference, there were some red flags here with this guy, as there usually are red flags. He actually appeared at a NATO event, and he was speaking, he was addressing the president of Ukraine, who technically isn't the president of Ukraine because his term expired, and he did this.
And now I want to hand it over to the president of Ukraine, who has as much courage as he has determination. Ladies and gentlemen, President Putin.
You've got to be kidding me. Every little mistake he makes is going to... Oh, God. I mean, that's before this actual press conference. So anyway, the press conference, well, I thought it was going to be at 6:30. Apparently, it was originally scheduled for 5:30. I tuned in at 6:30. He wasn't ready, or something was going on. 7 o'clock came, 7:15. The guy was more than 40 minutes late for this press conference. So I'm thinking, what the heck is going on? I got tired of listening to the media talk over and over about this whole situation, just stalling. Anyway, so he finally showed up. He walked on the stage. He had a strong walk for him, and he was speaking clearly. He was giving a little speech. He was started off pretty strong. You know it's bad when you give the president of the United States credit for being able to walk onto stage and speak. But anyway, I think they had a teleprompter set up for his little speech or something. I don't know. Anyway, he started off strong, but then they started asking him some questions, and that's when it got a little bit, he made some really bizarre comments. First of all these reporters who asked questions were pre-selected, pre-approved. Anyway, let me show you one thing. A lot of people question who's really running the White House, who's really running the show. Well, this doesn't help.
Only the advice of my commander-in-chief, the chief of staff of the military, as well as the Secretary of Defense and our intelligence people. Following the advice of my commander-in-chief,
Aren't you supposed to be the commander-in-chief? I'm just wondering, okay? Who's the commander-in-chief? Is it his wife? I don't know. At one point, he talked about his debate performance. They asked him about that. And he sort of threw his staff under the bus, and then he mentioned his wife. Pay close attention to this.
Pace myself. In the next debate, I'm not going to be traveling in the 15 time zones a week before. Anyway, that's what it was about.
You had 7-8 days to prepare for this damn debate at Camp David. What are you talking about?
That's what it was about. And by the way, even with that, I love my staff. But they add things. They add things all the time. At the very end. I'm catching hell from my wife for that. Anyway.
Well, I mean, stuff gets added when you have a really important job. I mean, especially when you're in a leadership position, stuff gets added. You know, is it just me or what? I mean, it's... That wasn't even the worst part. I mean, the worst part for me, I heard it. I thought, like, what the hell did he just say? I went on Twitter, and by the way, you can find me on Twitter. I've been pretty active on Twitter ever since the presidential debate. I must remain active on Twitter. I haven't been on Twitter in years, but I'm on it now. This, for me, was the most ridiculous part of the debate.
I wouldn't have picked Vice President Trump to be vice president, but I think she was not qualified to be president. So let's start there. Number one.
He wouldn't have picked Vice President Trump to be vice president if she wasn't qualified to be, what the hell?
I wouldn't have picked Vice President Trump to be vice president, but I think she was not qualified to be president. So let's start there.
Oh, God. Let's just say Blinken, who's on the staff, he'll never be a great poker player. Just look at his reaction to this. When I heard that, I thought, like, what the hell? Did he really just mix up Kamala Harris with Trump?
I wouldn't have picked Vice President Trump to be vice president, but I think she was not qualified to be president. So let's start there.
Oh, goodness. He's like, oh, no, not again. Oh, God. When I was a kid, I was always wondering what the future would be like. Would we have flying cars? What type of technology will we have in 2025? If you would have told me that we would have had a president of the United States who struggled to walk and talk, I would have looked at you like you were crazy. Like, what the hell are you talking about? Because when I was growing up, we had Slick Willie. We had President Bill Clinton. Okay, you know, the guy who said, depends on your definition of is. I mean, oh my God, it's... All right, so there's some talk that they're going to have him removed. He's going to step down by Sunday. We'll see if it actually happens. I don't think he's really running the show. I mean, is Jill going to say, okay, you can step down? Because like you said...
Following the advice of my commander in chief, my chief.
Wow. So I just want to give you guys my reaction to this whole big boy press conference. I'm going to say this one more time. As far as Trump, as long as he doesn't pick Nikki Haley, he'll be all right. Marco Rubio, I don't see the point of that. I don't think he's going to help him get Latino voters. He'll help him with the establishment, with the neocons, but I don't see the point of being President Trump and running as a person that he's running and selecting a neocon to be right underneath you. Because then you create an incentive for the powers of either to remove you and elevate that neocon. But anyway, Burgum, I don't have a problem with him, the governor from North Dakota. I don't have a problem with J.D. Vance. He would be a pretty exciting pick. He's very young, very energetic. Tim Scott, it will help him with the establishment people. I would prefer Tim Scott over Marco Rubio. Tulsi Gabbard, she's an independent. She's really exciting. She was a lieutenant colonel. I don't agree with her on a number of issues, but I do think she cares about the country, and she's not a neocon. She's not a warmonger. So she would be a really interesting pick if he actually wants to appeal to not just women, but really independent voters. That would be a really exciting pick. Ben Carson, I think if he was 10 years younger, maybe that would make sense. But he's still a pretty impressive man. Vivek Ramaswamy, he always said he didn't want to be the number two guy anyway, but Vivek Ramaswamy would have been my choice for president. I think he would have been a fantastic pick. So I recommend that Trump goes on the positive. Focus on the positive. Focus on what he can do in the next 4 years to improve the lives of the American people. Because you don't know who's going to be running against. They can't spend the whole convention making fun of Biden. I actually wouldn't do that. I would focus on the convention talking about the future. Not necessarily poking fun of Biden. Because that's a whole... You don't even want to get involved in that mess. And when did the Democrats end up replacing Biden anyway? After the GOP convention. Then you just basically wasted a whole bunch of time talking to the American people about how inept Biden is. How inept Harris is. And neither one may not even end up being the nominee. So if you have a platform in front of the American people, talk about what you're actually going to do to help the American people. That's my recommendation. I hope that we actually see that. You guys share your thoughts. Thoughts on Vice President Trump.